you, welcome to Cafe Enoma and welcome to our first time single take honest reaction to the Fratellis for the Girl. This is the first time that I'm going to listen to the Fratellis, but I don't know why I know this name, Fratellis, for some reason. I heard it somewhere, in what reference I don't know, but I'm aware of this name, Fratellis. This is the first time I'm going to listen to the song for the girl. It's a Patreon request. And here on Enoma, this is what we do. We listen to music first time, in most cases 99% of the time. And we listen to the music that is requested to us without taking a pause, without interrupting the music, without disrespecting the music that we are going to react to. Provided that the patron has followed all the guidelines, submission guidelines, when they request the request what they want us to react to. It is very important to follow those guidelines, otherwise we just will not be able to react to songs that are requested, because there are already copyright guidelines of the platform that restrict us when the artists are not safe to react to. And secondly, in the past and even now, a lot of people who have been taking advantage of the system that we have on Patreon, that patrons join and we react to almost everything that they request, as long as it meets the guidelines of the platform. What happens, a lot of times we come across songs that are very objectionable or something that really doesn't suit us or go down well with us. We are two very, very highly educated people giving reactions to the music. Most of the times it is from the other side of the world and we have no clue what it is about. But just because we do not know before starting the reaction what it is about, that does not mean that we stand for anything that is requested or we will just go gaga over whatever is requested. We have our own set of guidelines and ethics, and we would like to enhance that. We would like to put that forward before we select or before we react to the songs that we are requested. So it's a humble request to all the patrons who will be watching this reaction video to please follow the submission guidelines that are provided. Otherwise, we will be left with no other choice but not to react to those songs.
Yeah, the Fratellis for the Girl. Totally unknown band, I guess, or artist in this part of the world. So it's basically us giving exposure to this artist,
rather
than them helping our channel grow. Wow, interesting.
I'm a player, no one can hear a word to tell what the girl was singing. bones when I was sending the roses. She was breaking my bones when I was busting her noses. She would tell me a secret, I would lose her the next bit. Young, I'll please as you ease it, makes her sick in a bad way. And all the while the girl sang, la 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 la, she sang, kicking so my sweetheart.
Interesting song, interesting song. I love the music, I love the singer's voice, and I like the tune also, and that hook, la 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 la. I like that part, but I don't know much about the lyrics, what it's trying to say really. Seems to suggest a lot of things, but I'm not clear about most of it. It went too fast for me, quite plainly. It was repeated, part of it was repeated towards the end.
Yeah.
But still I just didn't get it. It was kind of suggesting how different they both are, you know, but I don't know. I have to take it line by line before I actually put my finger on it or even talk about it in detail.
I found the energy very, 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 very high. I like this la 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 la, and especially when the la 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 was going on, the guitar was playing at that time or what, but it was making it sound even more, much better than what it sounds like when only la 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 is done. So that time, very good merging of the instrument as well as the other members of the band who did that. I like the vocalist. It was a fast song. It was pretty fast and very short song. All these lines were done and you don't even know what exactly is going on between them. There are things going on. I think it is not going well. She is going different way, he is going different way. They both fought or what? Or he hit someone else and she was at the same time troubling him. I don't know what exactly he was talking about, but they both aren't they aren't walking the same path. That much is very sure. I like the music as well. It was fun. The energy is great of the Fratellis.
Yeah.
Oh, should I read the lyrics for us to know what exactly it is since we have enough time?
Yeah, I can read it.
Well, she said, I know, but I just can't tell. Okay. Everything you have just been saying, Lucy was there as well in the dark when the kids in the band were playing. Oh, what does that mean? Who's this Lucy now? No one can hear a word I tell what the girl was singing. She must have been 16 or 18. I'm just fast caring. She was into the stones when I was into the roses. Still doesn't ring a bell to me what exactly, who's Lucy. They were in the dark, she was there, somebody was 16 or 18. I don't know what is happening here. She was breaking my bones when I was bursting their noses.
Very violent.
Something is happening. 16, 18, he wouldn't care. I don't know what is happening here. And who's this Lucy?
She would tell me a secret, I would lose it the next day. You're not pleased that you're easy, makes you sick in a bad way. And all the while the girl sang la 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 la, and she sang, kickings for my sweetheart, bruises that I just don't miss. And she said, I can't love you anymore like this. It's kind of an explicit relationship, some kind of affair or some kind which is not legal.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe an underage girl or something like that. Something's not right here with this whole song. That's why I don't even want to get deeper into it, because it's something just doesn't make sense here, what's going on.
Mm-hmm.
It sounded really good the way it was sung, but now that I'm going through these lines on the screen, I think there's something, you know, something quite not right with the way this two are operating or this relationship between them. She doesn't want to have any more of this. Or she said, oh no, let me, yes, why don't you kill me? It's all sung in a very fun way, but it's kind of violent and
yeah,
suggesting all kinds of things in the middle of the lines. So it's quite disturbing for me. Reading these lines is a little bit too disturbing. It may be taken, I guess, most people who heard this song whenever it was released, it sounds like it's of the 60s or 70s, I think. Probably when it was released, most people just grooved to it, enjoyed it based on the music and the way it was sung.
Yeah.
The tempo, the speed, of it all really must have pumped them up and really must have made them happy listening to it. But when I go through these lines, it's an altogether different story. I guarantee you that there's something seriously wrong here. It may suggest it's a young relationship between a young boy and girl.
Yeah.
It could be that, but at the same time, there's a lot of violent lines which I don't like. Whenever violence comes in the music, it's not something that I like to associate with in any way. I'm not here to promote such songs or talk great things about the music. Any band that promotes violence, not my cup of tea.
It sounds crazy. It does sound crazy. I don't know what is up with both of them. They both don't know what exactly is happening or what they are doing. Both of them seem to be very harsh towards each other. The girl also seems to be harsh towards him, and he too. And then at the same time, he's seeing someone else as well. A lot of things happening. It sounds like two young, very, very young, immature couple. Doing anything and everything.
Yeah, I was dead by Sunday.
I know, and then
half dead, scared, just trying to please her. And then there's a talk of an affair that he's having.
Yeah.
If he's with this girl, he's suddenly with her best friend. She's getting the pills when I was into her best friend. So he's directly suggesting about, you know, a hardcore affair that he's having with her best friend.
Yeah.
While she is probably in hospital or she is recovering from all that.
Something.
Yeah. He's up to his own tricks. Mm-hmm. So I don't really want to associate with anyone like that. You know, to be honest, it is a fun song. That's a fun, ironic side of it. You know, when people listen to what I'm talking right now, they'll say, oh, ease up Savio and ease up Kirti. If Kirti also joins me, she's on her own trip right now, maybe. So people say, ease up Savio. It's just a light song. It's just a fun song. Don't bother about the lines. You know, these are the things that kill people. These kind of songs kill a lot of people.
Because it's said in such a fun way.
It also destroys relationships. You know, it may be all fun and joy to you. I'm not sitting here to promote music like this. You know, I come from a culture and I'm very proud of belonging to a culture which is primarily non-violent in nature. We are one of the only cultures probably in the world which is peaceful, non-violent and loving by nature. Most other cultures, and if we talk about Buddhism, yes, even that has started from India. And Buddha was an Indian. Most people don't know that. The most popular person...
Why would they not know it?
The most popular person in China and Japan is an Indian. Or was an Indian. Gautama Buddha. So it's as simple as that. So people don't even know that. So when we react to songs which have a lot of violence in the lines, talking about extramarital affairs and all that, some of those lines I don't get. I just don't get. It's one of the 10 commandments in my religion of Christianity. That thou shalt not, you know... do things to the neighbor's wife, and it's very clear that we are brought up on those kind of principles.
Yeah.
And then there's the other part of Indian, being Indian, that is non-violent, and a lot of other things, peaceful. So yeah, I don't get these lines. You know, I think it's a fun song, but at the same time, I think
it is hiding
a lot of things in the lines, which will influence a lot of people, and probably did influence a lot of people who actually took those lyrics to heart. Let's just do the same thing. And it's okay.
Yeah.
It's alright. It's not alright. It's not okay. Today people actually a couple of times a client told me things about, I asked them, do you know much about India? It was a third or fourth session with both of them. One which was the third and one the fourth. So I knew a bit about them, they knew a bit about my way of counseling. And I asked them, do you know much about India? One of them said, I know India is a land of call center people. I know India is a land of cobras and elephants. I know India is a land of, you know, tandoori chicken or something like that. Chicken tikka masala, I think. And one person said more or less the same things and some other things too. I said, if you think that's what India is, and probably I'll tell you that America is a land of cocaine, ecstasy, opioids, guns, and a whole lot more. So if that's what the impression is about India, and it's all fun and games, you don't really want to learn more about other cultures, you assume that's what it is, then even we have a very shallow view of certain countries in the other side of the world. Not just America, but many other countries. Because if you look at them and their stats of different things, you will know that, oh, it's dangerous to even walk out on the streets of certain states in those countries. Forget about, you know, talking about it in your home. You're anyhow being scrutinized, watched, recorded all the time in a couple of countries. So there's no freedom of speech, there's no freedom of expression, creativity, anything. And when you try something like that, you know what I'm talking about. And if you already have, you already know what I'm talking about. So these kind of songs is all fun and games. But when you get in the lyrics and it sounds so crazy in there, I think it's someone with a mental disorder probably who's written these lyrics.
For a girl. For the girl, right?
Yeah,
I don't know if it was about or for the girl.
Any final thoughts, Kirti? Anything else you'd like to say? We are done almost, but any final thoughts?
The final thoughts are, I couldn't agree more with you, what you said about the song, what about the lyrics. These things definitely and definitely influence society, where it is supposed to be a major part of. At times when we don't understand lyrics, people suddenly come and say, this is what it meant. It becomes all about the lyrics in those songs. And why not about these songs? They all have lyrics and they are saying something. And the better worded, the positive worded they are, the better it is for the society. When we have enough problems, enough chaos, enough hatred, enough negativity to keep on adding it with the lyrics of the music as well. That's what I would say.
Mm.
Thank you for watching.